What's up, everyone? Wet work here. It was raining, but now it's nice out. Also, yeah, we don't have the background. Again, well, here's my excuse. Well, here's why it's not up. I didn't feel like putting it up. If you've noticed, I'm back, and I've done a lot of Halo videos recently. I mean, it's only two, but that's a lot. And today we are back with another Dollar Store Toys video. This is the fourth one, and as I've promised, we have Transformers. Now, I have better versions of these that were bought at, like, Target, except for the Optimus Prime, and I am calling him Jetstorm because I don't know his name. But yeah, let's get into it, starting with the man, the myth, the legend himself, Optimus Prime. Now, I think these were trying to go for a G1-esque look. That's what I get from this Optimus Prime, but, like, Bumblebee and, like, especially Megatron, it's not really G1 at all. But yeah, here's his truck mode. It's the first time Transformers are making an appearance. Probably because I didn't even bother watching the last night. I do have a lot of Transformers, if you wanted to know. Yeah, here he is. He's got his silver windows, silver front, and some lights. Stickers for his logos, which is why it doesn't really exist. Silver for these. Got blue there, black here. Got spinning wheel. Only four of the wheels actually spin. This, you can tell this was a dollar store toy because two of the wheels don't spin. And they didn't even bother painting that silver to make it look consistent. It does roll. If you get a little tap, it'll move a bit. It does roll, but let's get into the transformation. You can kind of really already see what's going to happen. So first we splay these out. Lift this up. Spin this around. What? Open it up. Pop the arms back, and then push the head up. Boom, we have Optimus Prime. It looks good from the front. The back, though, it's trash. All of his joints are loose, but the head actually does look pretty good. He's got silver and his eyes painted. The blue's painted. It's really hard to see. Okay, maybe if I just put it all the way back, zoom up. Yeah, you can see he's got his eyes painted, he's got his face guard thing painted. It looks alright. He just can't stand. Oh, he can. Oh yeah, articulation. His head moves down that far. His arms rotate. Elbows bend and rotate. He's got rotation up here. His legs move forward, not that much, and out. And that's it for him. Let's lay him back there. Now, sorry, I have a cold that won't go away. I just had to take a break for a second. But eyes back with a paper towel, because you never know when you have to sneeze. So yeah, let's... Ew. Just found the largest hair in existence on my hand. Ew, this is what happens when you wash your hands, and then you just start touching your carpet. Okay. Also had to use the restroom. Why am I sharing this with you? Let's move on to my favorite Transformer of all time. Bumblebee. He has moving wheels, but his knees. This is the worst design. Look, his knees pop out. Look at that. Look at that. So, like, all the paint right there, is they're not his knees, they're like the back of his legs. But they scrape on it, but he does go pretty good. His car mode, he's got some red outline there, and some black stripes back here, some red, some black on the front. He's got an Autobot symbol. Now, I've noticed there's a variant of this. What I mean is, there's one with the Autobot symbol right here. Intense, I know. He's got some silver windows, but no one cares about the car mode. And let's get to the vehicle mode. What? No, we're in vehicle mode. Let's transform this guy. So first you pop out the legs, move his feetsies, unpeg them. He's kind of already half transformed. Pop his arms out. Pop his arms out! Rotate this back. And rotate these here. And we have Bumblebee. I love this dude. This is my first of these, by the way, because of course it was. I love his face. Yeah, I'm gonna have to zoom up. But yeah, it just looks so nice. It's got the little horns. He's got a little smile with blue eyes. He just looks really nice. He's got his arms molded in here with little fists. Yeah, you can see how his legs are messed up. He's got a huge backpack, but I don't know. Makes him look like a kid. But he can't stand. He can't stand. What in the world? Oh, it's also all the white stuff that's lined up is eraser because I put my pictures on this. Yeah, he can't stand. His legs are loose. So let's sit him down. I have a better version of him. Bringing in this one. Yeah, it's got a nice car. And a way better and more accurate robot mode that is yellow and not orangish yellow. So yeah, there's that. So let's just put that dude back down. Let's get to some Decepticons. Let's start off with the man, the myth, the legend himself, Megatron. He's a tank. Why? I don't know. He's supposed to be a gun, but that's violent. I mean, the tank does look really nice. I gotta give him that. And it does roll. It has wheels. And it rolls nice. Look at this. Tap. For a dollar store toy, this is really nice, although you can totally tell he's a Decepticon. This is the problem I have with Transformers toys. They just drop the logo of what side they're on the middle of the car. Number one, what if you're trying to, like, have, like, a spy transformer? Number two, what if you just want to use it as a car? I don't know. Let's transform it. Let's pop his arms out. Also, yeah, this can kind of rotate. Not really. Have the better version right here. I do gotta say... Hold on. Why'd I say hold on? Hold on to your seatbelt! Do you guys say? Even though this can turn and all, I think this one has a better vehicle mode. It looks legitimately like a tank besides these fists and this Decepticon symbol. And the fact that you can kind of see his head. It looks like a regular tank. But for here, you can see his hands. Turn around, you can totally see a body. When you look, you can definitely see it, and it just doesn't look like a tank. And this does. You gotta give this one that. And you pop it out. Oh yeah, articulation with Bumblebee. His arms rotate, his legs move forward and out and back. And then you pop his legs out. Like that. Pop this down, push this down, rotate his head. And he does look really cool. He's the only one that doesn't have a messed up body. What I mean by that is he doesn't have any loose joints, which is so nice. Even though he's like, as I got him like around the same time I got Optimus Prime. I just love how he looks. He just looks so cool. He's got a huge case of the boobs here. But yeah, his articulation, this is the only problem with him. Go to punch somebody, his arms fly up really high. But he has head articulation, which is cool. But that's because of the transformation. His legs move forward, out. And he has knees. That's because of his transformation, too. Now, comparing the two Megatrons, I don't know. I mean, they both look really good. But I kind of like the dollar store one. But yeah, this is supposed to be about trashy dollar store toys, but sometimes they're really good. Just drop you back there. Huh? Now let's get on the Starscream. Now here's where we come with inconsistent scales. Transformers is the most inconsistent scaling in existence. It makes no sense. Like, you'll have like a jet the same size as a truck, but a truck tower over like a Camaro. Like, sometimes Optimus Prime and Bumblebee, Optimus Prime's vehicle mode will tower over him, but Starscream's will be the exact same size. Makes no sense, I know. In this case, they're all the exact same size. This is one of the less hidden ones. It does look really good, except I gotta give it again to the better one. Because number one, the scale is just way bigger, and it just looks way more like a jet. They both hide their parts down here. But yeah, transforming him, you just pop this out. Pop this out. Rotate these back. Hold on. Push these down, pop these back, pop these down and down, pop the head up. Kablam, dude. Oh, hold on. Yeah, turn the head, push that down. Then you can see the cockpit goes into the cockpit right there, and you have Starscream. Starscream's got some nice red. He does look really nice as a robot. Gotta give him that. And the back isn't much to look at. These are supposed to be guns. I know, right? Those are supposed to be guns. They don't look anything like them. Now, here are the two Starscreams together. I don't know. His face looks really nice, though. He's got some black around it. Some red eyes. It's really cool. I think he's pretty neat. He also can stand. Now, let's get to Jetstorm. I'm calling him that. I don't think that's his actual name. I'm like 100% positive it's probably not his name. I picked him up. This is actually my second Starscream because I lost the first one. But I picked him up because when I saw him, I was like, Look how cool that is. This is cool. Like, a sleek black jet with, like, dark blue around it looks so cool. I think it looks cooler than Starscream. Comparing these two is like comparing night to day. One's like full on white and one's full on black, but I think the black one looks way cooler. It looks more like a Decepticon. Like, and it looks more ominous. It just looks it just looks cool. And it looks more threatening, because if you see like a white jet flying towards you, see like a black jet flying towards you, that looks more ominous and spooky. It can like blend in the night. I just like the color. I just like the black color on it better than the white. Transforming, it's the exact same. Now the robot mode. He's got a bad case of loose legs. He does have knees, though. Now, going over the articulation for both of these, because they're the exact same. Heads turn, arms move out, legs move out, not forward. Knees bend and rotate. But now we get to the... It looks really cool, yes, but it kind of looks bland compared to the Starscream one. I don't know. But yeah, that's it for Transformers. Robots in disguise. I have a lot more Transformers. Dealio. And because I have it, I just want to show it off. Isn't that a Transformers Prime Bumblebee so adorable? This action feature from the McDonald's toy looks like he's just rock, paper, scissors, shoot! I don't like the new Transformers TV show. I prefer Prime. That's Transformers. That's it for this video. See you all next time. Bye-bye. Make sure to subscribe, click the bell icon thingy if you haven't already. And this has been Dollar Store Toys. And always remember, they're not all trash. Just think. Not all of them are trash. Most of them are trash. There are a few gems. Which is why this show isn't horrible. Because all of them are gems. The ones I've bought are gems, except for the third episode. The third episode really shows how bad they can get. See you all next time. Bye-bye.